The orbiter was backed out of the processing facility in early July, just after the 4th of July holiday. The boosters and external tank were stacked in parallel in the vehicle assembly building while the work was going on in the orbiter processing facility. The countdown demonstration test with the flight crew was conducted just a few weeks ago, and the flight crew was certified in emergency escape procedures. This is the orbiter access arm as it was attached to the vehicle. Once Discovery rolled to the pad last month, and the rotating service structure was then moved into position around the orbiter to allow the installation of the payloads and also access to various parts of the vehicle for the Kennedy launch team. Payloads were installed into the payload bay out at the launch pad in the vertical position. And the payload bay doors were closed for flight early Tuesday morning during our countdown. Countdown began on time at the T-minus 43-hour mark at about 3 p.m. on Monday. Count has been going very smoothly, which leads us up to this morning. It's traditional for the crew to arrive several days before the launch. They go through flight data file reviews, and the commander and pilot practice approaches and landings to the shuttle landing facility to hone their skills. They practice in the shuttle training aircraft. Crew also has medical exams while here at KSC prior to launch, and they perform fit checks of their flight crew equipment. All continuing to go well out at the launch pad. The final inspection team is making their way up and down the launch tower, looking for any loose items or any ice or frost formation. They do wear the bright orange suits so that we can keep track of the crew as they wander around the launch pad. And we have live pictures of the flight crew in the crew quarters. We've got Commander Kurt Brown, who's just walked into the suit-up room following the weather briefing. This is his fourth flight, and he has overall responsibility for commanding the flight. This will be his first flight as commander. He served as pilot of three previous missions on STS-92 in 1992, 94, and 96. Kent Rominger. As pilot, he will assist Brown at the flight controls. This will be his third flight and his birthday today. He's 41 years old. He will also be assisting Commander during the rendezvous and retrieval of the CRISTA-SPAS payload, and will also be involved in several payloads, including the solid surface combustion experiment. We have Canadian astronaut Bjarni Tryggvason making his first flight on the shuttle today. Across the room, we have the mission specialist. We've got Jan Davis. She's making her third flight today. She's the payload commander with overall responsibility of servicing tasks. She will operate the robot arm to deploy and retrieve the German CRISTA-SPAS payload. And we have mission specialist Robert Curbeam making his first flight today on the shuttle. He serves as flight engineer and will assist the commander and pilot with ascent and reentry checklists and in monitoring all vehicle systems. And we have mission specialist Stephen Robinson. This will be his first flight. He is the prime mission specialist for the CRISTA-SPAS payload, and he will work with Jan Davis on with the robot arm activity and will operate several experiments. There is some fog in the KSC area, and that is expected to burn away as the sun continues to rise here in Florida. And looking for favorable weather conditions for our launch of Discovery today. All countdown events are going well. We expect the crew to arrive at the launch pad's white room at about 8 a.m. Got a lot of well-wishers standing by, ready to wish the crew well before their journey into space. Crew's getting ready for a 10-day mission. We have views now in the crew cabin, and we have guest commentator Marsha Ivins here to help explain what's going on.
What you see here is the commander, Kurt Brown, getting into the commander seat on the left. Joe Tanner, who is the astronaut support person, the ASP, helping him. It's a little difficult to climb up in the vertical position and to get in the seat, so Joe is holding onto his parachute while Kurt gets into the seat. I was going to ask him to, as he holds the parachute, pull himself all the way down into the seat to get a good fit in there so they can get the harnesses on him. At the same time the commander is being strapped in, we have MS-3, Steve Robinson, being strapped in by Carlos, who is our awesome suit tech on the mid-deck. This goes on in parallel so that all the crew can get in a timely fashion. The same as Joe is helping on the flight deck, Carlos holds on to the parachute. Steve's got a strap connected to the locker you can see him holding onto now, like a chinning strap that allows him to position himself correctly on the parachute as he gets in. Now we see the birthday boy getting into his seat, the pilot. He's holding on to two handrails, one in the center of the near the windows and one on his right side. And then as they hold his parachute, he pulls himself down into the seat. Bjarni is now in the PS-1 seat. You can see his chinning strap that he's got to get himself positioned in the seat. And Carlos will be connecting his cooling water. Last crew member in, Bob Curbeam, in the MS-2 seat.
Well, I've got you here. I'll give you step 570 to work for the clock if you want for the perform the fuel cell purge on channel 153.
Okay, we'll put that into work as well.
Do you need a QC there?
And we heard that poll by NASA test director Doug Lyons of the launch team indicating that they are ready to continue on with launch today. Standing by now for Jim Harrington, the launch director, to conduct his poll of the management team.
12, I'll run a poll at this time.
Copy.
Payload director.
Payload to go.
After that, engineering director.
Engineering to go.
Copy that. Safety and mission assurance.
Safety and mission assurance is go, Jim.
Copy that. Range weather.
Roger, sir. We have low constraints to launch, Trevor.
And ops manager.
Ops manager, we're not, the MNT is not tracking anything, and looks like we're go for launch. You're cleared to proceed with the launch count.
Copy that. And Discovery, looks like everything's ready to go. You guys have a great mission, and we'll see you back here at the conclusion of the mission, and NTD, you are cleared to launch.
Copy that, sir. Thank you. Attention all stations. The countdown clock will pick up at T-minus 9 minutes. And 2 minutes and 20 seconds.
T-minus 5 minutes.
Orbiter AT start.
DLT OTC, perform APU start.
APU start inward.
And CDR, reconfigure heaters.
The vent hood is situated at the top of the external tank. That will be retracted away in the next few seconds. And the external tank is being pressurized for flight.
DLT OTC, clear the caution warning memory. Verify no unexpected errors.
That's inward, OTC. OTC PLT, warning memory cleared. No unexpected errors.
Copy. And flight crew, close and lock your visors. Initiate O2 flow. On behalf of the launch team, good luck with your mission. And Rommel, happy birthday. We're about to light your candles.
Thanks for that birthday wish. Will be the two best candles I ever had. And Discovery, copy visors and suit O2.
PLS is go for ET LH2 pressurization.
Water will be dumped onto the launch platform in a few seconds to help suppress the sound and shock of the thrust produced by the shuttle at launch. T-minus 15 seconds. 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8. We have a go for main engine start. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Booster ignition and liftoff of Discovery on a mission to study planet Earth.
Roll program, Houston.
Roger, roll, Discovery.
Houston is now controlling. The roll maneuver is complete. Discovery is now in a heads-down, wings-level position. All three main engines now throttling down to 67% of rated thrust as the orbiter passes through the area of maximum aerodynamic pressure on the vehicle in the lower regions of the Earth's atmosphere. Telemetry indicates all three auxiliary power units and fuel cells continuing to perform well.
Throttle back to about 67% on all three of the main engines. And looking for Mach 1 right now, making sure the tapes match on both sides, and they did, and we continued on up. And right about now is when the engines start throttling again, throttling up to 104%, the main engines, that is.
Discovery, go ahead, throttle up.
Copy, go ahead, throttle up.
1 minute, 22 seconds into the flight, Discovery's three liquid-fueled engines are now back at full throttle, 104% of rated thrust. Discovery now traveling at a speed of 1,900 miles per hour.
I just called the tail off of the SRBs, and we should see SEP right about now. And there was the big flash of light, and now we've rode to the next, and now we're just on the main engines, and got about five and a half more minutes to orbit.
Again, telemetry currently indicating all three main engines, auxiliary power units, and fuel cells continuing to perform well. Discovery now at a speed of 2,800 miles per hour. Downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, 27 miles. Discovery now at an altitude of 367. Downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, 370 miles.
Discovery, single engine Zaragoza, 104.
Copy, single engine Zaragoza, 104.
Now 8 minutes 43 seconds into the flight, the booster officer here in Mission Control has confirmed an on-time main engine cutoff.
Discovery, Houston, we show a nominal MECO. Ohms 1 is not required. You have a go for the ET photo DTO.
Copy. Nominal MECO, Ohms 1, not required.
Houston Discovery, we're in the low hover position and would like to maneuver to the SPAS release position.
You have a go to maneuver to release. Discovery Houston, we're about a minute to the ZOE. We'll be back with you at 7 hours, 9 minutes.
Copy, Alan, 7 hours, 9 minutes.
Number 339-25. Number 440:00. Or number 540:30.
The ice cap runs in a good chunk of the way through the brownie and motion stuff, but when I was running config mid at one point, I got the SCP comm lost error, and when I tried to do cold reboot on the system, I get as far as starting on track, and then I get a bit of hieroglyphics, and that's where I've been ending for the last little while. I'm not able to get back by that point.
We copy and we'll look into it, Bjarni.
Discovery with BDS data when you're ready to copy.
We're ready.
TP flex.
Go ahead.
Yeah, on the flight plan, Ellen, TP flex troubleshooting part B, would you like to get into that?
This is the workstation where we operated the robotic arm, which is a Japanese robotic arm, which will be part of the Japanese arm on the space station. These are the two hand controllers. We have a computer here which also controls the arm, as well as some switches.
Go ahead, Rommel.
Yeah, before we exceeded the min temperature, we got to 6%. You all happy with that, or do you want me to dump that last percent out?
No, you're just fine where you are.
Okay, copy.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Swiss, Hellbob, dead.
We have a good picture.
And Houston Discovery, good handheld laser mark, and it agrees with RARA radar.
Copy.
Houston, Discovery with Earth Vehicle status check.
Discovery Houston, we're 2 minutes from the ZOE. We'll be back with you at 0 hours, 17 minutes.
Copy, Houston. Talk to you at 17 minutes. And before you go, just, you probably see this, but we're about 125 feet closing at 0.25.
And Houston Discovery, DTO complete. We're backing out now.
Copy.
Houston Discovery, we show a good grapple.
Great job, Discovery. Congratulations on a very smooth rendezvous and grapple.
Okay.
And Jan, you can go ahead and put DEAC in work. Houston, we've upped linked orbit and target stake sectors and approxops covariance matrix.
Okay, we copy that.
MET, 9 days, 1 hour, 5-6 minutes, 40 seconds.
We copy.
Discovery, energy, ground track, and nav are go. Latest touchdown prediction is 2,600 feet at 195.
Copy. Energy, ground track, and nav are go, and 2,600 at 195.
Long-range cameras capturing Discovery at 103,000 feet altitude.
traveling 2,500 miles per hour. And Commander Kurt Brown now flying Discovery as the twin sonic booms announce the arrival of the orbiter in the landing site area. Time to touchdown, 3 minutes, 10 seconds.
Discovery on energy at the 180.
Copy, on at 180.
Discovery's altitude is 2,400 feet, traveling 375 miles per hour. And the landing gear is down and locked. Main gear touchdown. And nose gear touchdown. Discovery's rolling out on runway 33 at the Kennedy Space Center, completing 189 orbits of the Earth while traveling 4.7 million miles. STS-85 is the 23rd mission of Discovery and the 86th in the shuttle program's history.
Rommel, we're looking at the doors.